क्या एक बूंद सागर में परिवर्तन ला सकती है? फ्रेंड्स, आई टेक यू टू ए जर्नी वेयर यू वुड सी हाउ ए ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर और ड्रॉप ऑफ एम्बिशन कैन ब्रिंग नो चेंज इन द ओशन. सो दिस ऑल स्टार्टेड ईयर्स बैक व्हेन आई वाज इन विलेजेस, व्हेन माय एजुकेशन वाज इन विलेजेस. आई सॉ पीपल डाइंग ऑफ डॉग बाइट. So when I thought I became a doctor, I thought to help them, and I saw that if we study why people are dying, so it was unaffordability of the medicines. In rabid dog bite, we give two type of injections. One is vaccine and one is immunoglobulin. So people were not able to afford both the injections, and many of the people I saw dying. So this is a long journey of hard work, perseverance, fighting with the barriers and the lack of research activities in government hospitals. So we try to do something for in the interest of these patients. When we saw as doctors that the people are dying because they cannot afford these medicines, because these medicines cost around 35,000 rupees per person per course. So this was a very difficult job to do, because sitting in a district hospital, you're thinking of patients, doing something for the patients, and big protocols are there already in place. And when we realized that if something has to be done, this has to begin with ourselves only, because nobody else is going to take this issue, because this issue is not dear to many. Many don't want, maybe they don't think of low cost solutions for the poor people. Very few people think of doing that job, because that's very, very hard, painful and stressful, and in an environment when all around you are following set protocols. So this all happened when I tried to see the literature, I tried to see the protocols, how we can bring down the cost of these two injections that are given for a rabid dog bite. So while I was doing all this, so I came across a solution for at least for vaccine, that it can be given, you know, in a different route. Instead of giving intramuscular route, we can give it in intradermal route in the skin, and that can bring down the cost of the vaccine five times, from 2,250 rupees to 350 rupees per person per course. So when I realized this thing, and I was very confident that this protocol has already been recommended by WHO and has been endorsed by Government of India, I went to my chief medical officer saying, "Sir, there is some solution that we can do, we can apply in the interest of the poor patients." Then my chief medical officer, who was a medical specialist, was very surprised that you are telling me to implement this protocol despite all the endorsements. It is not being followed by any institution. No higher institution is, no towering institution are following this protocol. Why should a district hospital should start following such a protocol which is not time tested? So he told me, no, first you do your post graduation, you study. Further, only then you can talk of such protocols, because in such a small hospital, we cannot follow the protocol you're telling me, and you're not qualified also to say that we should follow this protocol. That qualification needs to be there, and you need to do post-graduation and come out with details of this protocol, how it can be followed. So that ultimately forced me to do my post-graduation when I was 41. I applied for ICMR Institute of Epidemiology in Chennai, and I went for post-graduation. So in between, in 2008, suddenly there was no vaccine available all around. So the same chief medical officer called me to come back and follow this protocol, do this intradermal vaccination, and that's how, in scarcity of the vaccine, we could immunize five times more people with the same number of vials. Otherwise, if we could have done this in the previous protocol, we could have immunized five times less people than what we could do now. So that's how little bit acceptability of this protocol came, which was already endorsed by WHO. So now when my chief medical officer saw that this can bring, no patient has died and they all have survived. So he was convinced and he made the vaccine free for all the patients, including poor patients. So that's how one component of the rabid dog bite treatment was made free to all. And when the story went out, all the chief medical officers of the state, all the 12 districts, they started slowly converting into this new route of intradermal vaccination. And that's how the vaccine was free by 2010 to everybody. So this was a great thing that I thought that had happened with the God's grace. And now little authorities were more acceptable to my ideas and what I was doing. So in between, I was thinking of making the second injection of rabies immunoglobulin affordable to the poor patients. And I was reading thousands of papers to do something for another injection, which is very costly. It is costing around 35,000 per person because it is made of human blood or horse blood. But many doctors prescribe human immunoglobulins than equine immunoglobulins because there is a danger of reaction with equine immunoglobulins. So human immunoglobulins are costing 35,000 rupees per person, so this, which is not affordable to every person, everybody. So I, after a lot of literature, I came to the conclusion that this rabies immunoglobulin, when given only into the wound, is essential component of this protocol, and giving rabies immunoglobulin into muscle is not required because the protocol, WHO protocol, was calculate the rabies immunoglobulin by weight of the patient and then give whatever volume there is there into the wound and give rest of the immunoglobulin into muscle. So I came to the conclusion after reading a lot of literature that giving into the muscle is not required. So that's what I wrote a protocol, and while I was thinking of implementing this new protocol onto the poor patients, suddenly in 2014, there was no immunoglobulin available in the market. There was acute shortage. Many people went up to Delhi and all the places, but they could not find rabies immunoglobulin. So one day I saw a patient who died despite vaccination. That day I called my authorities, my director health services, and I told him that we should do something for these patients in such a situation of scarcity of rabies immunoglobulin. He told me, do you talk to WHO? But how can I talk to WHO sitting in a small hospital? I have no links with the WHO to talk to. But still, I was thinking of what to do and how to do it. So we have NIMHANS is an institute which is WHO Collaborating Center for Rabies Research in India. So there I had Dr. S.N. Madhusudana, who was admirer of my work. And I contacted him. I told him that this is the protocol I have made. Can I implement this protocol on my patients in my hospital to save their lives in such a situation of scarcity of immunoglobulins? So he said, you go ahead, because I have done a similar protocol on mice, giving only into the wounds, and all mice have survived. So that's how I told him to give in writing, please, so that I can share your letter with the authorities and with the ethical committee. And he gave in writing, I shared the letter, got the clearances, and started this following this protocol since June 2014. So now we were injecting only into the rabies immunoglobulin, only into the wounds, and not giving into the muscle because there was none available in the market. So this is how we started, but it was not a small decision, because if something goes wrong, then definitely we would be liable for that. And that could have risked my job also. So many people threatened in between that if something wrong happens to us, we will sue you in the court of law. So, but we saw people surviving this protocol, even bitten by lab-confirmed rabid dogs. So we were confident that what we are doing is right. And we had mice experience. We have experience of Dr. S.N. Madhusudana. We have our own experience saying that people are surviving. So that's how this protocol was started, and very soon we injected these immunoglobulins in 269 patients, and the paper was published, and when the WHO people read this paper, they contacted me and asked me if I have more data. But by that time, everybody was being referred to our hospital, because in other hospitals there are no available. And that's how now the patients was 7,000. So that another paper was published of 7,000 people surviving even rabid dog bites. So this is how the second paper was read by people in a WHO expert group, and they further contacted us if we have more data. In the meantime, we have started this protocol on animals, cows, buffaloes, horses, and again, those animals also survived. So we said we don't have human data and we have no animal data available. So that's what we shared with them. And then that must have convinced WHO that 600 kg buffalo is being saved by one drop of immunoglobulin, by 60 kg of human being cannot be saved by the same amount of immunoglobulins. So that's all. That's all. This data was given to the WHO expert group, and that's how the WHO was convinced that we should change our protocol, and there is no need of giving immunoglobulin to the muscle. And that's how the price of the immunoglobulin, that was costing 35,000 rupees per person per course, came down to almost 350 rupees per person, which is 100 times less than what it was earlier. And there was 100% survival, not only of human beings, but of animals also. So I would say that with constant hard work, perseverance, motivation, and a definite will to do something for the humanity, for the, can change the world for the better. Thank you.